All right, what is up, fellow sleep enjoyers? Today we're listening to My Bloody Valentine's MBV. I don't know if this is a self-titled album. I don't know what this is. It came a long while after Loveless. If you didn't check out my Loveless review, it was actually my second album review that I did on this channel, so it's a bit rough. It's the first shoegaze album that I ever listened to. I've listened to maybe 5 to 10 albums in the shoegaze genre since. I'm very excited to check another one out today, right now. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I love and appreciate all y'all. Feel free to drop more recommendations in the comments, and I will get to the albums that did not make the poll. I like to read the lyrics on the screen. I know Spotify fucks up the lyrics a lot of the time. The lyrics are not here today. I have it on my phone. Track number one is She Found New. This one already feels way different from Loveless. Interesting for an intro. If I never really got into shoegaze before, then I would really like that a lot. I feel like if I heard that song on Loveless, my first listen, I would like that one the most. I'll stop referring to Loveless. I'm sorry. This is its own thing. But yeah, incredibly atmospheric. I was expecting those kind of guitar sounds, but I wasn't expecting, you know, it to just feel so prolonged and, you know, space-like. I was more focused on the sound of that rather than the lyrics. I think when it comes to a lot of the vague, you know, short little lyrics, I'm just gonna try to pay more attention to the sound, because I feel like that's what they want me to pay attention to. Maybe because, you know, the lyrics aren't even on here. Maybe that's the artist's decision. So let's hop into track number two, which is Only Tomorrow. See, this is kind of the sound that I was expecting more. Yeah. Oh, I was gonna say, I like that vocal effect right there, and then the fucking guitar came back in like that. Oh, I love that part. I enjoyed that one heavy, more than the first song for sure. I feel like that would have been a better intro for me personally. Yeah, just a lot more variety within the instrumental. I loved the guitar riff on the tail end of that. It was maybe just about escaping with a person for the night and then, spending a night with them, then loving them in the morning. Maybe that's what it was about. I'm not gonna assume anything though. I feel like I personally would enjoy these songs more if they were like maybe 4.5, 5 minutes, but I'm not gonna be picky. I'm not gonna be picky. That's because that's stupid. I'm not doing that. Track number three is Who Sees You. This is such an interesting chord progression. Think that he's kind of talking more about the feelings that arise during the nighttime. He mentions the stars, maybe they're just laying out in the stars. I don't know if this is the kind of music that I would lay out in the stars too. I don't know if that's for me. The sound of it in general, I loved. All right, I loved. I think more than the second one, this one might be my go-to right now. That instrumental bridge was probably my favorite part of the song right there when that guitar came in, because usually I feel like, if there's more than one guitar on the songs, then they usually blend in with each other. Track number four is This and Yes. This one's dreamy as fuck. Dreamy as fuck. This is so stimulating. I don't know why, but it's so stimulating. I really like it. It's gonna melt away now. So, did she just say again for the whole thing? I don't know. The atmosphere in that was fucking crazy. I was zoned out. I'm so glad that there was barely any vocals on that. And, it was just kind of aid the instrumental when they did show up. Although, I would have never been able to guess that she was saying the words again. I really did not know what was happening at all, but I'm a fan. The main thing that I find similar to this listening experience to Loveless, and this is the last time I mention this album, maybe. I was pretty stunned and shocked. And at first, I thought that it was just because of the genre or something I wasn't used to. But I still find myself during this album kind of like trying to configure it to the sound that starts. It still kind of stuns me. So I think maybe that's just a trait that these guys have in their music that it just brings out in me. Track number five is If I Am. Oh, what is this? Oh, what is this? I would say probably the most like accessible song that I would probably show someone if I'm trying to get them into this album. I thought it was pretty nice. Some lyrics, intense lyrics about lust and desire. How this person only wants lust, but the singer seems to be okay with that. Like that song, not too much to say about it personally. So let's keep carrying on. Track number six is New You. Okay. I think the rhythm and the sound of this is my favorite so far, definitely. I'm rocking with this phaser, bro. Another song about love. That's my favorite one yet. That percussion, the rhythm of it all was just hitting me. It was kind of psychedelic, I feel like. I was kind of spacing out there. I was feeling the rhythm of it all. Love that one, man. That's my favorite on here, easily. I'm not sure if we're gonna get another one that's gonna top that one. I was just so woven into that one. I feel like that one kind of represented me as well. I think it's definitely gonna go on my goon list. And track number seven is In Another Way. Thank you. right? I might like this. Oh, I might. I'm gonna be honest. No, not for me. Not for me. Not for me. Nothing wrong with that song in particularly. You know, I actually started to like the guitars a little bit, and then I stopped. And I didn't start off the most inviting either. I don't know if that plays a role. It's definitely going to play a role if I ever decide to listen to this again. You know, I'm gonna get jump scared when I turn it on. Which, you know, some songs I love that do that, so that's not really a complaint. But, yeah, I'm just not really fucking with that one. Track number 8, from what I read, is an instrumental. All right. I like the way it build momentum. I did like that. I started liking the drums halfway through the song. So that was there. And yeah, let's close this John out. Track 9 is Wonder 2, as opposed to Wonder 1. They sample a plane or something? The guitars are like coming in waves. I have no idea how they're making this sound. I don't listen to that song that much. You know, I thought I had my hands wrapped around this album halfway in. I thought I had an idea of how it was gonna go, but it just, I appreciated and I admired a lot of the production aspects on that song. I like that one. I don't know how they made those plane sounding noises. I don't know if they sampled an actual plane sound. I doubt it. I think that they must have used a guitar. I think I did like this album. It's just, I can't stop fucking comparing. I just can't stop comparing. I'm really trying to. Would I have arranged this differently? Yes. I feel as if the only songs I'm likely going to return to are tracks 2, 3, and 5. New You. That's my one right there. I think New You might grow to be a top 5 track from them. For me. Other than that, I think I'll get some more stuff out of this project in the future, and I'm hoping to learn more about this band and, you know, why they stopped here, why they took years to make this, and things like that. I'm super interested in hiatuses and their meanings and shit like that. So, if you have any information about this album that you want to share with me in the comments, feel free to let me know and educate me, because I am uneducated. I simply am. I simply am. I always am. So yeah, thank you guys so much for being here. We will get to the Fleet Foxes album soon. I don't know about the other ones. I lost the poll. I'm gonna do those ones though. I will. All right, like I usually do. I feel like I've done every one that has lost in a poll at some point. Actually, I don't think so. I don't think I have, but I will. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I love and appreciate all y'all. Thank you for being here. And if I think I haven't done their debut, if I'm gonna do their debut, let me know. Let your guy know. So yeah. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you later.